Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Deepika. I talk everything about girls and bit more. So if you are new here, please do subscribe to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to talk about a very important topic for any kind of hair, that is how to protect your hair, especially if you have curly hair or wavy hair or damaged hair or dry kind of hair or even straight hair that frizzes out. This video is for you, so keep watching if you want to know what you can do, what things you can use. All the products that I'm going to show you have been provided by Hair Love, so I'm going to link everything in the description box below along with their website. And this video is also sponsored by them, and thank you so much guys for sponsoring this and working with me for making this a very important video. And I have been working with them since a long time, and we have like grown together, like we started around the same time. And let's start with it. So first of all, I'm going to remove this thing from my head. You must be wondering, what am I wearing on my head today? It's a bonnet made out of satin, and this is it. I have not opened the knot. So I have worn this specially to show you how I'm roaming around my place, especially if I have the curl definition that I want to preserve. I took a shower last night and then I woke up with it and I didn't remove it at all. I did my skincare wearing this only, and this is now I'm going to remove and show you actually how it turns out. So I'm going to remove this and you'll see. I had a really good wash day yesterday. So you can see this is how my hair is out of bonnet. Can you see all the shine and the definition that has been preserved with the use of this simple thing? This is a really innovative thing. Whoever invented it, it's a really amazing thing. So this is essentially what I do every day when I wake up. I just fluff my roots and just set my hair so they look good, and I'm done. I mean, investing in just something as simple as this makes life so much easier for curly and wavy girls. So I have fluffed all my hair and just set it right, and I can really say this is how I woke up. I didn't do anything to my hair, I just removed the bonnet and this is how I woke up. If you are really amazed like me, then keep watching this video, because I'm going to tell you why you have to wear this, how you have to wear this and everything, and what other things you can use. So we are getting a nice sunlight now, and I'm gonna enjoy this while I talk about it. So the first question is, what is protecting curly hair? So when it comes to curly and wavy hair, we often talk about how to style it, how to deep condition it, even I have talked about how to cut it. But we never talk about how to protect it. Once you're done styling, deep conditioning, drying your hair, what are you going to do after that? Are you going to wash it once again the next day? Are you going to style it again next day? What are you going to do with it? How you're going to sleep with it? So that answers the question, what is protecting curly hair? So once you have all the defined hair, now you have to protect it so that definition lasts, it doesn't tangle up, it doesn't frizz up a lot. So that's what is known as protecting curly hair. Also, when I say curly hair, I use it as an umbrella term for curly and wavy hair, basically textured hair. So because I cannot say all the time curly slash wavy hair, curly and wavy hair, I'm just using one word, one umbrella word, curly hair. So if you want to maintain the shape of your hair, please do not put it in a tight bun or a pony if you do not want any dents on your hair, especially if you have curly and wavy hair and you style your hair. And I often get these queries when people ask, my hair doesn't retain any shape. So when I ask them further questions, I get to know that they either comb or they put it in a tight pony or a bun, or just fiddle with their hair to make some hairstyle or anything. So please do not do this. If you really want to keep your hair away from face, when you are at home, use any of these tricks and trips and any of these hair accessories slash tools. And if you really want to keep your hair away from face when you're working, just put on a clip hair and just forget about it, or use a hairband or anything. But only put your hair up in a pony or a bun only if you are sure you do not want your hair to be looking amazing after removing the bun or the pony. We are going to quickly talk about how to actually do that using some products. So I'm going to show you a few things that I have from Hair Love, and I'm going to talk about them, the quality and everything. So starting off with my personal favorite, a hair bonnet. I use bonnet as much as possible. Like, I reach home and put on a bonnet. When I'm traveling, I board the bus and put on a bonnet. I board the train, I put on the bonnet. It's really handy stuff, and I think everyone should invest in it. This is the bonnet I have. It's a very pretty one. This print is called Desi Curly Bonnet and it's available with Hair Love. I think in the same pale shade or in the baby pink shade. It's really, really pretty. Fabric, the satin used is super luxurious. I have washed it many times and this quality is still the same. It is a double sided bonnet. Inside there's a plain satin. You can wear it from both the sides and there's floral print outside and I love florals. I'm going to include this video to show you how I actually wear it. This is a satin lycra band which you can tie around your head according to your comfort, and how I wear it when I'm washing face or when I have to take a shower. And this is how I sleep with the bonnet, like this, as easily as this. Can just keep, so my hair is protected inside the bonnet and it will be like this throughout the whole night. I can even not use this and still be not so careful about my hair, and I can twist and turn easily. It's going to be there on my head and no issues at all. I'm just gonna wake up fresh in the morning just like that, remove my bonnet, and the good curls are still there, as easy as that. And when I'm traveling also, I put on the bonnet. I just don't care what people are going to think. They don't have to refresh or wash or deep condition my hair. I'm responsible for taking care of my hair. So I don't care when I'm traveling what people are going to think about what is she wearing on her head. I just don't care. I have another bonnet from Hair Love, which is a silk bonnet, and I got it 1 year back. And I have used it a lot, but I don't use it anymore. This one, blue satin, a silk bonnet actually, and I have washed it many times and it's not really in a condition to wear anymore. The softness of the silk is gone because I used to just don't care and wash it in the machine. Please don't do that with your silk. I really prefer satin over silk anyways because it's cheaper in quality. It's so slippery. I get a good quality at a lower rate and I don't have to worry about how the fabric quality is going to turn out, if it's real or not. I have used it a lot and I loved it. I have posted a lot of videos with even this one on my Instagram last year, but now that I have this slippery satin bonnet, I really like it. Now coming on to the quality thing, Hair Love has really improved. First they had this satin lycra band. This was made to fit for your head, and people often had issues with the size, but then they came out with the band thing, and now you can tie it according to your head size. But I really think they should have made it a bit longer, because when I tie it, I have like this much only left to tie. So I think it should have been a little bigger for bigger head size. When we are talking about bonnet, I have to tell you there are different sizes of bonnet available in the market, and with Hair Love there are, I think, 3 or 4 sizes available with them. The regular size, the jumbo size, this long bonnet. I think they also have a medium long bonnet. I think so. So the regular and the jumbo one are like circular one. They don't have a tail like this. The regular and jumbo, those are great for people with short hair. Even with hair like mine, the jumbo will be fine. If you like to make pineapple and then sleep, then that's great for you. But I do not like to make pineapple at all. It ruins my curl pattern, so I do not like to do that. Plus I keep on cutting and growing out my hair, so I'm not sure which size I want. So if you are also not sure which size you want, if you want to grow out your hair, if you want to keep it short, then I would really suggest you long bonnet would be great. You are going to just buy once and just keep using it. And bonnet is a really great option if you do not like hair on your face. For example, if you are working in kitchen, you cannot put it when you are at work, but at home you can. Once I am home, I really like to put on the bonnet so my hair doesn't fall on my face. I do not like to really tie it because it really stretches out my hair. So unless my hair is already stretched out and frizzy and waiting for a wash or a refresh, I do not like to tie my hair. So I would suggest you get a long bonnet. You can use it anytime, no matter what hair length you have. So yeah, that was all about bonnet for me. If you really want to know if you should buy it or not, I would suggest everyone should. The only kind of people who would not like to wear a bonnet are the ones who do not like something on their head. It gives them migraine or headache. So bonnet is my personal favorite, but what other alternatives do you have? For example, hair buff. I don't have a hair buff because I don't use it, but it's like a tube like thing made of satin, so it's available with Hair Love also. You can go for it. I have not used it, so I cannot say much about it, but I have seen a lot of people loving it. For the ones who do not like anything on their head while they are sleeping or when they are at home, I would really suggest them to not get it if you get a headache really easily. You can definitely tie the hair bonnet really loose so it doesn't hurt your head. It happens with me too, so I don't tie it tight. Now I have... And now that it's a habit for me to put on the bonnet, it's not really painful for me because I don't really tie it tight. It's really, really comfortable. But still, if you do not like it, then you also have other alternatives. For example, I have a really, really pretty Hair Love prints are so pretty. The latest collection they got few months back, they got such pretty floral prints, and who doesn't love that? I have this big, like, let me show you how big it is. This big square scarf. It's really pretty. It's a green one with red flowers on it. I have used it in every way possible. Like, bonnet was wet, I use this one as a bonnet. I tied it in a way so it looked like a bonnet, and I also use it as an accessory, like putting on a band like thing on my head or putting it around my neck like this, under a jacket or anything. Especially in winters, it was perfect. It was really, really pretty. Super soft as you can imagine, and the material is really thick, so you don't have to worry about it getting torn away. I think it's going to last me ages. So what you can do with it is you can just spread it on your pillow and just lay my head on that.
This is how I sleep in summers, with all my hair above my head.
Just like that, I twist and turn, but I have a habit of just keeping the hair away from my head, and I just keep, even when I'm sleeping, so I just keep it away. Even if I twist and turn, and that's all. I wake up with really nice looking hair, all fresh, no tangles, nothing. Another way you can use this multi-purpose scarf is when you are traveling. For example, you have a train seat or a bus seat or a flight seat, or even in movie theater, you can just spread it on the back of your seat and just lay your head like that. You don't have to worry about it getting frizzed up at the back of your head. That happens a lot with me. That is how I figured out I can fix it. Another very important use of this one is when you are drying your hair, especially in winters and you're wearing thick woolens with a lot of texture on it. When my hair is wet, I really like to be a Superman and protect my wet hair, because when it's touching the back of my clothes, it's going to frizz up, especially when there are woolen clothes. So I just like to either wear a satin robe or wear it like this. It's really, really comfortable this way, and my wet hair is touching the satin and not the woolen cloth, and it doesn't frizz up at the nape of my neck, so that's great. And talking about frizzing up at the nape of neck, my hair really, really tangles up and frizzes up at the nape of my neck if it's not frizzing up here. So when I'm home and my hair is down and looking good, I really like to wear a bonnet. I either wear a bonnet or put on scarf like this, so that it touches the satin and not the cloth. And it really, really, really helps in avoiding all the tangles at the nape of my neck. And those are really painful tangles. Like, lagta hai khana ban gaya. So this trick really, really helps. Do try it. Now the issue with the scarf is that you have to put it on every time you want to sleep, and the moment you forget it, your curls will really get frizzed up and everything. So a more permanent solution would be to get satin pillowcases. So Hair Love India has them in many prints and many solid colors, so you can just pick them up according to your bed sheets and just put it on and just forget about it. You can sleep on them anytime. And I have a single one, so when I do not have my scarf or my bonnet, I just put it on and remove in the morning, because it's a single one. I have a double bed. It's a really big one, and the stitching is like perfect. It's like stitched really, really nicely. It has a zipper here that you can pull. The stitching everywhere is like perfect, and from the inside as well, there's interlocking, so you don't have to worry about all the stitches coming out. So it's a really, really, really good quality. You can definitely invest in them, especially if you like the soft and satiny kind of material. These are really cool. Now the next thing I have with me is again a multi-purpose thing that you can use anytime, and I love them. They are really famous. What is it called? Scrunchies. These are the scrunchies from Hair Love India. Hair Love India is known for their pretty and super comfortable, super reliable scrunchies. Last year they sent me many scrunchies and from that I picked up this pretty pink one in satin. Satin again, my favorite. And I have been using it like anything. I have washed it so many times. I have used it, my mom used it, and we have washed it so many times, but the quality is still intact. It has become a little loose, but it's perfect for me. Only one thread has come out and look at the stitching and everything. It's like perfect. When they first came out with their scrunchies, I do not have the older prototype, but they were not really good, and I also discussed with them that they really need to revamp the design of their scrunchies, and many of their customers did, and they really did that, and then they improved the design I think one or two times again. So the current ones are these ones. They are really fluffy and thick inside, and the stitching is like perfect. This is a satin one, and they have various colors and sizes and fabrics. Now the different sizes are according to the purpose. For example, if you want to make a pineapple, you can just put on the baby scrunchie and you don't have to twist it. It will just fit your hair perfectly. So this is daddy scrunchie. If you have thick hair and want to make a pineapple, you can use the bigger one and not twist it around, and it will not put a dent on your hair. And this is their printed satin scrunchie in old but beautiful pattern. If you want to make a ponytail, you can just buy the printed ones or put on the plain ones, and these are really really nice. I use them all the time. This one I don't remember, it has already stretched out anyway, but this is my go-to. This is always in my handbag. And then we have Italian one. This is called Italian fabric. It's a crinkled fabric and it's really really pretty. These are a little expensive, but you can really use them for decorating your bun over your head. It looks really really cool, especially the color. They have super amazing colors and it's really luxurious and really soft. I have another red one in silk, and my mom uses it most of the time. I don't have it right now. If you want to know which one should you buy, I would really suggest you to go for the satin ones, either the printed ones or the solid ones, and they are really really cool. So for making a pineapple, these scrunchies are super good because they won't cause that crazy dent those thin rubber bands make on your head. And when you pull out these scrunchies, even if you're making, it won't pull your hair, it won't give you crazy kind of hair fall that happens with rubber bands and those thin kind of bands. That won't happen in this case. I have used it a lot. There's a big, big, big difference. Now this is how I actually like to use these satin scrunchies to protect my hair without my curls getting stretched. A very loose low pony without twisting and turning the satin scrunchie, and to keep the hair in place at the top of my head, I use a clutch clip. Very comfortable, it doesn't hurt, it doesn't stretch my curls, and no tangles, no hair loss because of the scrunchies. It's all good and I really like this method. Now when you are at home, you can use any of these scrunchies to make a pineapple according to the density of your hair. But I don't really like to make a pineapple because when I put on a pineapple, it makes it so comfortable, especially in summers. But when I remove it, all my hair is like stretched out. It's I don't really like to make pineapple. A lot of people like to make pineapple, especially people with long hair, because even if it stretches out, the rest of their hair is really nice and defined, but the top part is a bit stretched out. But it doesn't really look bad when you have long hair. But when you have short hair, only this much of hair, even a single centimeter of your head comes under the spotlight, so you have to be very careful. And the last thing that I have from Hair Love is this satin lycra beanie. And what you have to do is you can just put it on and put on a helmet or a cap or hat or a woolen cap or anything you want, and it won't frizz up your hair or create static or just make it so wonky when you are traveling, especially for people who like to wear helmets. This is really 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 useful. I have a video on my Instagram on how to use it in different ways, and I'll link that in the description box below. You can just watch that one and see how to actually use it. Recently I went on a weekend trip and I took this one with me because it was really cold there, and I was really sure I am gonna need woolen caps, and I went with this one, and it just hides inside the caps and helmets. You won't be able to identify, no one will be able to identify it's there inside while it's protecting your hair, and when you remove it, your hair is all good. It's not stretched out or frizzed up or anything. So yeah, this one's a really 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 useful one. So this was all about me on how to actually protect your hair once you're done styling, washing, deep conditioning and doing everything. If you want to make your hair actually healthy, if you want to avoid all the dryness and all the tangles and all the frizz, no matter what kind of hair you have to protect your hair, and I hope all these tricks and tips really really help. And if you are going to do this, you will definitely see a lot of change in your hair, like instantly. put on the bonnet, wake up the next day and tell me how it goes for you. So do let me know in the comment section how you actually protect your hair, if pineapple works for you at all or not, and let me know what other tips and tricks one can do, and I'll see you in the next video.